Hey everybody, this is Don over Johnny's Used Cars. Today I'm showing this 2009 new body design Mazda Axela wagon. It's got 51,000 kilometers on it, which is only 32,000 miles. Before we get started, I'd like to let you know that we do have on the lot discounts. So the price you're seeing on the website right now will not be the final price when you come on the lot. Also, if you're arriving to Okinawa soon or you just arrived, please make sure to stop by Johnny's Used Cars as soon as you can and have a look around. Even before you get yourself a driver's license, there are benefits, okay? So with that, let's go ahead and take a look around the vehicle and show you the inside, the features inside. But first, I'd like to ask you to please watch the video until the end. I do go over a lot of information. My video is going to answer a lot of your questions. So things like the JCI, the road tax, the warranty, I cover all that and more. So please bear with me until the end. You have all the answers. If not, go ahead and contact me or stop on by. This Mazda Axela wagon is a 5-passenger vehicle in the 3-series category. It's the larger category. Road tax per year is going to be 19,000 yen, which is about $160 right now with the current exchange rate. Road tax is due every April-May time frame. So we'll take every for you this year. You won't have to worry about it until next. Now you have two options to pay for this. First one being US dollars cash outright, which could get you a larger discount. Or you can take advantage of 0% financing for 24 months with zero down. Yes, we don't have a down payment requirement, but if you want to put something down to reduce your overall monthly payment, you can. A lot of our customers do like 500 to 1,000. Some do half, some do more. Up to you. Before I go inside, I was like showing the rain guards. Rain guards will allow you to roll your windows down a little bit. This way, if it rains, it's not going to get it wet inside. More important feature benefit is it's going to give you that cross ventilation, get that extremely hot air out, and always get yourself a good windshield visor. Now, this is just coming in, so it's going to be a little dirty, but let's jump on in, get this baby started. So it does have the keyless on you, so as long as it's on your person, it is a push start, foot on the brake, push this one time, then it goes. Leave those up there for now. Oh, let's turn that radio off. Sorry, Troy. All right, 51,352 on the odometer. I showed you a couple of warning lights. That blue one there is your new temperature gauge. So it's gonna be blue when the engine's cool. When the engine warms up, it's gonna go away, and it'll be red if it's overheating. Be on the lookout for that. That one there, obviously your low fuel indicator. And like I said, it just came in. That one right there, obviously your seatbelt one. Make sure you wear your seatbelts. They do give tickets on and off base. And then that one right there is your emergency brake. It's not a low pressure tire gauge. I know it looks similar, but it's a hand brake. So when you disengage, it goes away. Engage, it comes right back on. Other than that, just a real simple, straightforward, straight-in instrument cluster. Anything pops up on the dash while you're driving, please pull over, find out what it is, take the necessary action. Off to the left here, you have this little display. It doesn't give you, I'm not exactly sure all the settings for that. Then you do have your air conditioning settings right there on that display. Okay, then you have your radio, your air conditioning controls, non-smoking ashtray and power outlet, shifter, handbrake as I told you about, cup holders, and center console slash armrest, which is going to give you a little extra space and another power outlet. Continuing off to the left, you have this two-tier glove box of manuals right there, and then you can go all the way back for some storage, and then a little bit of storage and cup holder on each door panel. That is your passenger space over there. You get red roof flare hanging out, and then this is the space I have on my side. I am 5'11", as everybody loves knowing. Seat is all the way back, all the way down. I can drive as is or slide this up an inch or two and still be comfortable driving. This one does have a sunglass compartment up here, and then let's go eye level. That's my eye level right there. Really can't see anything past the windshield wipers like on most vehicles. Come on back. Now normally there's a time I show you the auction sheet showing you that this is a non-accident vehicle from mainland Japan. Please keep that in mind, non-accident vehicle from mainland. All these other dealers can't tell you that. We can on all our cars. But because it just came in, I keep those inside of the office. Once it's been detailed, I'm going to put it up here on the sun visor on the driver's side. And then this guy hiding up here, that's your ETC reader, electronic toll collector. This works like easy pass in the States if you're able to get the card for it for the expressway over here. Okay? Before we go to the back seat, let's show you a couple other things. So you have a little compartment here, maybe for some coins or whatnot, and then your hood release right underneath it. And then please don't forget, on the floor here, you do have your gas cover release. And then over here, you have your mirror controls and your window controls. And then you control the door locks by pushing that right there, okay? So to turn off the car, you don't have to have your foot on brake, just push this one time and it goes. Let's go to the back seat here. I'm trying to hurry so it doesn't rain on me, all right? All right, so with the seat all the way back, all the way down, I'm exactly flush with the back of the seat. And again, I could have slid this up a couple inches and still be comfortable driving. Nothing as far as storage on the back of the driver's seat, but you do have pocket storage on the back of the passenger seat. As always, be careful what you put in there. Doesn't have a lot of give. And then you do have a cup holder on each door panel, along with a center console that's going to give you two more cup holders or armrest. All right, let's go into the back here. You do have to push this button in order to open it, and you have all this decent space back here. Now this privacy cover, it can come out if you have to haul stuff by pushing that button in, and that one's already pushed in. Let me see if I can reach that. Okay, so you get have that all that space open with the seats down. Okay, let's go to the front here, show the engine compartment. They're gonna wrap this video up because I feel a couple raindrops coming. Come on. All right, and there you have it. And this is a 1.5 liter engine, which will be cleaned during the detailing process. And there you have it. 2009 Mazda Axela new body design wagon, okay? 51,000 kilometers on it, which again, it's only 32,000 miles. Military prices at a 5,300 with additional military discount, we'll get it down to 5,100. Again, while you're here, please ask the information guy about on-the-lot discounts, and you will get a lower price on this. But for now, the 5,100 is going to include a two-year JCI, the one-year bumper-to-bumper full warranty, the 2022 road tax, and a 10% sales tax is already included. Only thing on top is going to be the American insurance requirement, whether you go liability or full coverage, which is totally up to you, and we can assist you with that here. Touching on the warranties out here, yes, there are two-year warranties out here. However, they're not the best thing since sliced bread. Stop on by, we'll explain why. So don't forget, two ways to pay for it, US dollars cash outright, or take advantage of our 0% financing for 24 months with zero down. Either way, we're good to go. So thank you very much for watching. Take care. Hope to see you soon.